Capacity and solar consumption has come a long way. A couple years ago, we were using standard solar panels made out of silicone. They're heavy, big, bulky, not very practical, but they've come a long way. Now we have certain solar panels that you can put on the side of your windows that will absorb a little bit of energy for you, some extra energy. It won't be as efficient as your big bulky panels up top, but you can put those on your window now and they'll absorb anywhere from 13 to 18% of solar energy, whereas your solar panels on top will consume or convert about 20 to 22% of your solar energy. So we've come a long way so far. As far as batteries go, we have started to use lithium-ion batteries developed by Elon Musk at Tesla. This was predicted years ago by my friend Frierson Michener out of Florence, Alabama. He works for a coaching company called Senator Coaches. They redo coaches and everything, and they're big into battery consumption. But he said that Elon Musk will be developing some sort of battery that won't be just one big one like we used to have, like acid cell batteries. Now we have a bunch of little batteries that make it easier to isolate issues that you have maybe with your AC unit or your refrigerator or something like that. So well done, Elon, thank you, sir. As far as Wi-Fi capability goes, mobile hotspots are still the gig. Satellite is unreliable, but mobile hotspots are still the gig. We are seeing unlimited data plans coming from Verizon, T-Mobile, Sprint, AT&T, the big companies and whatnot, whereas satellite, it's expensive, it's not very reliable, and you have to put a big solar dish on top of your bus or van, so it's not the most convenient. But we've come a long way, and we continue to keep we've come a long way, and we continue to keep progressing, so we could see some new technology coming out with mobile hotspots or satellite, or maybe even a combination of the two here in the near future. So those are just, you know, some predictions that have come true, and predicted that way back a couple years ago, and it's good to see that all this technology is coming about. Back when I built my van, I didn't do any sort of Wi-Fi mobile hotspot or satellite hotspot or anything like that, just because I wanted to stay off the grid, and it was a little too expensive for me at the time, and it wasn't something that I wasn't gonna use, so I figured I might as well just skip on that and put more money towards solar panels. My solar kit cost about $1,000 in 2017. In 2020, that same kit came down to about $600, and you know, in the next couple years they've come down even further, or we project them to keep coming down further as technology advances and whatnot. So happy to see the same kits and installation processes and everything staying relatively similar and also going down in price as technology advances. So that's big information, and that's big news for anyone who's trying to redo a bus. I personally love it because I have a new idea in mind, a new bus that I want to redo. So I'd be looking into getting multiple different solar panels with multiple different batteries and Wi-Fi hotspots and everything I need. So looking good here.